Hey guys, this is Fred from Pretty Fly Games, and today we're going to continue with our top-down car controller built in Unity. I've been getting a lot of questions from viewers about how to add local multiplayer support to this game. Right now, when you're pressing the accelerator key, all of the cars are listening to the same keyboard layouts and also gamepad, so it's impossible to have local multiplayer support. So today we're gonna look at how you can have different keyboard layouts and also get the different gamepads to react to only certain players. So the important part here is actually the input script. So let's start that in Visual Studio. So the first change we need to make in Visual Studio to the car input handler is the ability to determine which player is actually controlling the car. So we will add an integer called player number and we will default it to 1. Then we'll go down into our update function and remove these inputs that we are getting for just the player 1. And instead of using if statements, I will use a switch statement that I prefer when it comes to many values. So the switch statement is similar to an if statement, but with less text. So we feed in the player number, and then we look at a case, and we say that, okay, if it is 1, then this code will be executed, that is between the 1 and the break. So in this case, we want to get only the input for player 1, so we need to define this in Unit later on, horizontal underscore p1, and the same for vertical p1. And then we do the same for all the other players, and in this case we will add support for 4 players. So make case number 2, if player number 2 is playing, then get the input from player 2, and so on. And then we don't have to do any changes. So let's run this in Unity and see what happens. So in Unity, let's duplicate the car. So we get 4 cars here, and let's rename them. So we have P1, P2, P3, and P4. Now we need to change the values of P2 in the input handler. So we'll change it to player number 2. P3 is going to be 3, and P4 is going to be 4. Now, if we press the play button and we press an input, then we're going to get some errors. So we get an argument exception, input access horizontal, P4 is not set up, and for all others as well. And the reason for this is because we haven't changed the input handler in Unity. So let's do that. So let's go to Edit and then press Project Settings, and then we will select the Input Manager. Here we can see all the inputs that are defined, and the size is 18. So there are 18 slots in this array. So let's increase that to 19, and then we get a new cancel button here. But we want to have our own, so let's change that. So we will first start with the play 1 horizontal input. And let's add a descriptive name so we remember what it is. And we will use the descriptive name keyboard steer. And then we need a positive button for it. So what happens when it's positive, or we give a positive value? So we use the right button for that. And then the negative button is that we're going to use the left arrow key. And we're not going to have any joystick buttons on this one. And that's it for this one. We can leave all the default values as they are. And then we do the same thing for the vertical. So let's add that. And we need to change it into the correct name. So we called it vertical P1. So let's change the descriptive name to keyboard plus gamepad acceleration brake, because we will use both the gamepad and the keyboard in this case. And then we have the negative button, so which key are we going to use to brake? So we'll use the down arrow, the positive is going to be the up arrow. And here comes a little bit of the tricky part. So we want to have the negative button on our gamepad as an alternative key. So let's add joystick button or joystick number 1 button 1. This is the red button on an Xbox game controller. And then similarly, we want to have the ability to accelerate with the green button, which is joystick number 1 and button 0. And then we can leave all the settings as they are. So let's save this and just try it in Unity and see what happens. So if we press play now and we use the arrow keys, then the first player will only move and we can steer left to right. So that works great, but we haven't defined player 2 and player 3 and player 4. So let's go back into the input manager and we'll do that. So let me prepare all the other players and we'll just cut that part because it's pretty boring. So there, all done. Now we have a horizontal P1, which is a keyboard steer, and it's using the left and right button. And then we have a vertical P1, which is using the down button and the up button, and joystick 1, button 1, joystick 1, button 0. Then we have P2, which is using the A key to steer left and the D key to steer right. And it also have mouse support, joystick 2, button 1, and joystick 2, button 0. And then we have the same setup for all of the players. Now, there is one part that we need to add as well, and that is the ability to steer with gamepads, because now we have only added the acceleration, and those need a special case. So let's add a few more. So let's just collapse all of these real quickly. And then we increase the array size to 27, so we get one more slot. And here we will add the support for the gamepad. So what we will do is we will call it again, horizontal P1, and we will call the description we will have as gamepad turn, and we will remove the different buttons here. And we will also change some of the values. So we will change the gravity to 1 and the dead zone to 0.3, because we don't want it to be super sensitive when we have the gamepad around the thumbstick, when it's around the sort of zero value. Otherwise, it's going to be a little bit hard to steer. And you have something called snapback, which is when you let go of a thumbstick on an Xbox controller, it actually will swing back a little bit because of the spring. So if you have this to zero, then the car will be very hard to control. And then I like to turn down the sensitivity a little bit on the gamepad, so I'll put it to 0.9. And this is a value that you can try out and see what works best for you. And then we will change the type to joystick axis, and it's going to be the x-axis, and we're going to get input from joystick number 1. And then we need to do that for all the other players, so I will just do it right now. Let's cut to that. So now I've added the horizontal P1, P2, P3, P4 with the gamepad turn, and ensure that you have the correct joystick for the correct player, and also that is the x-axis. So if we close this and run our game, then it will react to both input from keyboard. Let's start with the gamepad. So here's play 1 on the gamepad, and then we'll take another gamepad. So here's play 2 on the other gamepad, and then we'll take player 3 on the keyboard. So it can go back and forth like that, and it can turn, and the same thing for player 4. So it's quite tedious to add these settings, or doing these settings in the project settings. So to help you along the way, I will provide a way of copying my input manager. So let's show you how to do that. So if you open your project in Explorer and go into project settings, you will find a file called InputManager.asset. This contains all the settings for your input manager, all the buttons, keyboards, etc. Now, in the video description, I've provided a link where you can download my input manager. And what you do is you download that and copy it over this file. Then instantly you will have all the settings for play 1, play 2, play 3, etc. So there you have it. That's all you need to be able to support local multiplayer in your game. And of course you can add more inputs to support the trigger buttons and anything you want really on the gamepad. Personally, I'm using another plugin called Rewired because it's a lot easier to handle support for different consoles and also a lot easier to map out the different players, and it has some cases which is nice when it comes to handling different inputs and how gamepads are connected to the game. But that's not something you need, but it's something I recommend that you check out if you want to have good local multiplayer support. So this concludes this session. I hope you liked the video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and also hit the subscribe button. Here's an example from our game, Total Arcade Racing, which uses this component for its physics, inputs and other parts. You can find the game on Steam, Xbox and Nintendo Switch. Please take it for a spin if you want.